In these days of stock market uncertainty, perhaps it is just as well to stress again the fundamental soundness of the vast majority of the economic activities of this nation. After all, the stock market is not the major barometer of business. I say that with all due regard for the admitted value of the services of the exchange, and with all due sympathy for the many who have lost and lost heavily in its recent operations. But after all, there is something deeper that lies behind our economic fabric, and that is based upon more fundamental factors. Not the least of these is the matter of education, and in that I include not simply the training of our youth, but also the equipment of our business executives. Certainly at no stage in our economic history have they been served so well as they are today with statistical and other factual data. Our progress in scientific research, in technical advance, has been notable and has contributed mightily to the general economic strength of the nation. Lastly, I would mention particularly the great growth of our savings, as manifested perhaps more clearly than in any other way in the 100 billions of totals of our life insurance, a mighty symbol, so to speak, of the power and the frugality of our people. After all, perhaps the best evidence of the economic progress that we have made in recent years and the solidity of our present position has been the steadiness of prices, of services and of commodities, as contrasted with those of securities. There is ample evidence here, I think, of the profound basic strength of our whole economic position. Our industrial employment is stronger this year than ever before. Our exports are larger. We may say then that with all due regard for stock market uncertainties, our industry and our commerce